Going on, everyone. Welcome, Rabid here, and today we're going to be doing a setup guide on the SUPERSCALER k. Or wait a minute, did I just say SUPERSCALER? Halt, rewind. So this is actually known as the ColEngine P2-X, which is formerly known as the SUPERSCALER k10 plus. So supposedly this is a bunch of upgrades over the k10. Now overall it does have slightly less hash rate than the original k10, but what they did here is they have a smaller form factor. Supposedly that is running cooler than the previous one. They did remove the SD card and now everything is kind of built within its own memory or something here. That increased the speed of the burn process. And the burn process is what it does do when you have to switch the algorithm. So it'll load the other algorithms faster than the original K10, which does have that in there. So, you know, it is about $1,000 cheaper as well. So if you are looking for one of these, I know I did live stream a little bit of information about this thing earlier on the week, around Saturday or so, and there was a lot of interest in this miner. So, you know, go ahead, check it out. You can email Laura from Jingle Mining yourself. I will have that down in the description, or you can just click that link and code RABIDMINING will grant you 1% off. So this is just gonna be a setup guide. I still have to test everything out just to see exactly how well this miner does do. But if you look right here, you can see that it does mine Alephium, Radiant, Carlson, Nexella, as well as Ironfish. So it looks like Alephium is about 37 gigahash at 458 watts. We have Radiant coming in at 22.2 gigahash at about 1236 watts. Carlson is 32 gigahash at 1484. NXL will be the same hash rate as well as power consumption. It's the same algorithm. And Ironfish about 332 gigahash at 1395 watts. So I will be testing out all those algorithms and confirm if the numbers are accurate or not. But right now, let's figure out how to set this up, because you may have already been ordering these, or you may just get one in very, very soon, and you're probably curious what that process is like. So let's jump into it. All right, so when you first plug in all the power and everything, get it plugged in, Ethernet, all that good stuff, and fire it up for the first time, you're not going to be able to log in through the IP, whether you're finding it through your router or not. You're actually going to need the tool. So there's a couple things that you got to download before you even get going into it. So over here at the Jingle Mining website, we'll have links to these directly down in the description. But here you just click on this miner, the ColEngine P2, click on that, scroll on down, and over here you will see, oh, I passed it, I apologize. So here you can see, please click this to read on the ColEngine V2 original SUPERSCALER K10. So here's a setup tutorial if you want to go through that, but you're going to need to click here and get the P2 firmware and manual. So if you click on that, that'll bring you to this page, and this is everything you need. So here's the P2 tool. Now I don't recommend a download unless you know how to speak Chinese, or I guess read Chinese. So I was messing around with this forever, trying to figure it out using Google Translate and everything, so I knew where everything was. And then eventually I found out you can use the actual K10 tool. So I will have that link. This is the download here for the K10 SUPERSCALER tool. You just select a different model, which I'll show you in a minute, and it will connect and you can do everything through that. But you are gonna have to download the P2X release package. This has all your burning algorithms in it. So when we open up that, once you download it, you'll see firmware or image. So it will have the latest firmware here, as well as images. And here you can see RXD, KLS, so Carlson hash. It goes based on the algorithm. So every coin on Carlson hash will be able to use through this file here. Blake 3, and obviously Alephium. We will be using Alephium for the setup process, and it is currently mining Carlson, so I can show you how to switch that algorithm. So you can see we click here, click again. This is the ISO for the Alephium bitstream. So we're gonna have to load that into our miner before we can actually mine the Alephium coin. And you're gonna have to do this every single time you do switch the algorithms, not necessarily the coins, but the algorithm on the coin it's on. If you do have to switch that algo, you are gonna have to reburn this algo into it. So I'm gonna open up my tools just to show you here. This is the P2 tool, which I told you, you're gonna have to know how to speak Chinese, or I guess read Chinese. So we're gonna open up that miner tool, and you know, hopefully everything's defaulted. We hit okay, and we can see everything is in Chinese. So I had no idea how to work this miner because I was, you know, taking a screenshot and putting each piece into Google Translate image and all that stuff, trying to figure out what everything said, until I finally found out that the K10 tool does work. So I'm going to close this out because we don't need to use that one. I'm going to go back to downloads here, and I'm going to find the K10 tool right here, and I'm going to open this one up right there. And now you can see if you choose K103, it will work. I'm just going to show you what happens if you have the wrong one chosen. Then once you go to scan your machine, no IP is going to show up. So you do have to choose the proper version. So when I went through here, I found that K103 does work. So we're going to open that up, scan machine, and we can see my machine popped up. So there we go. We have an English version using the K10 tool. And for the pool of choice, I'm going to be utilizing Hero Miners to show you how to set this up. Number one, they are the sponsor of today's video, so much appreciated. Number two, they also are the largest altcoin mining pool for all these altcoins out there. And number three, they're actually in partnership with SuperScaler, which means they will support all the coins that SuperScaler does come out with, as well as SuperScaler will be tweaking towards the Hero Miners pool. So all these things together, this makes us want to set up towards Hero Miners. All right, so you can see it is on the algorithm Carlson right now. So the first thing I like to do is set up all the pool stuff first. That way it is there. So we're going to come in. I'm going to select Alephium here. And now we got to select our mining pool parameters. Now you do have to utilize the Stratum plus TCP. Allegedly, I've been using it every time. I didn't try it without it, but you're going to have that in here first. So I went ahead and inputted that in here, Stratum plus TCP :// And now we need our pool parameters. So I'm going to come into Hero Miners here, choose the closest Stratum to you. I am rocking USA West, even though I'm in Canada and there is an Eastern Canada, but I do have a lower latency to this one right here. So I'm going to right click this, copy it, bring it up here, and simply put that in right there. Now you're going to need your wallet address. So I'm going to scroll down here. It's already kind of defaulted in here because I have been using Hero Miners for Alephium. So I'm going to copy this in, and then I'm going to bring up my tool again and just paste that in right here. Now by default, they actually use for the worker name, the last, I think it's 4 or 5 digits of your actual IP address on your local. It's not your public one, so it doesn't matter if people see the number. So if you put in a worker name, like if I went period, P2-X here, it's gonna have my worker name as P2-X and then like 4 or 5 digits of the IP it's on. So I'm just gonna not even remove that because I know what this miner is. I'm just gonna rock it like that. For my pool parameter, I am gonna use default. Now it looks like sometimes on some of the Carlson hash ones, you do have to use fish here, so it kind of picks between the two. But for most of these, all you gotta choose is a pool parameter of default. So now that our pool is all set up, we're gonna actually have to burn the Alephium algorithm into this miner because we are switching algorithms here. So in order to do that, we're going to click on machine info on the far left. Make sure our machine is selected by hitting the check mark here. And then we're going to go into remote control because you don't want it mining while you're doing this. So I'm just going to hit stop run and hit OK. And we'll start to see it here. It'll say something. It'll switch. There we go. So it's going to say stopping. I totally forgot what it says, but that's what it does. So it says stopping. So now we're going to go to update and set here, and we're going to browse. So here you can see algorithm burn. So if you want to update your firmware, a new version comes out, this is where you do it right here is browse. And here is your firmware line where you put that in, then start update. It'd be the same process of stopping. Make sure you're not mining. But here I'm going to come in. We're going to hit browse. I am going to go back now to find the package we need. So I'm just going to go back all the way to downloads here, P2X release packages. Come in, image, and now I'm going to go to Alephium, and we need to upload this ISO file. So I'm going to open that, and now you can see everything has filled out where it should be. And I'm going to make sure this is selected. I always like to unclick it, click it on, make sure it's blue. And now we're going to hit algorithm burn. So this is what's programming the algorithm into the control board now. So we're going to click that. We're going to hit OK, and we're going to wait until the status does update here. It'll give us an OK prompt when it's ready to go. So it'll just take a couple seconds here, not too long. I am mine. There we go. So there we can see. And now, you know, something in Chinese pops up with the status, but it is now going to begin that process. So I come back onto here. I like to stop status, then start the status update again. And we will see it go from loading and begin the programming process, which could take anywhere from 3 to 10 minutes, depending on the algo and stuff. So just give it some time and it'll finally start updating to the latest one. So I'll let it sit so you guys can watch it do its thing. Okay, so now you can see it is complete. So now we're gonna go into our pool. As you know, we set this up earlier. This is why. Now all I gotta do is simply make sure we are clicked on it here. Click here. Now we're just gonna hit start set, which means engage, go, start mining everything we have set up here. So we're gonna hit this now, and it's gonna say okay. We see we got our status writing, you know, it's saying something. So this means it is okay, and I can hear it ramping up in the background. I'm going to the info, I'm gonna click on it, I'm gonna stop and then start again. That just means it's gonna keep doing. I think it keeps reading it anyway. I just do that every time just because. And now we're just gonna wait for it to load that bitstream, and we should begin mining Alephium. Now we're gonna see if it works or not. Sometimes it doesn't quite work. If you run into errors, you may have to reburn that algorithm. It does seem to work every time, but we may have to go into our remote control here and actually tell it to allow load algorithm. I'm not gonna hit that until we see what happens. Most of the time it will start working, but we may have to hit that button just in case we get an error and it starts to stop or something. So we're just gonna wait and see if it does begin mining or not. Okay, so it looks like it is begin mining. We didn't have to do the allow algo here. So everything looks like it worked as it should. We can see algorithm here is Alephium. We can see mining. Everything is starting. And again, if it started to say stopping or something accidentally, it's getting some error or something. We can't read the error. But if you go into your remote control here, all you'd have to do is click on allow load algorithm and then it should fire up. If not, then I would recommend going back through the process of reburning that algorithm by stopping your miner again and so on and repeat what we did. So right now we should be up and running on Alephium. We will check the pool out and see if we're gaining some hash rate or not. All right, coming into the pool, we can see we do have hash rate, and here's the worker name I was kind of telling you about, 001133, so 246, so it actually gives the last six digits of my IP. Example, you know, 192.161, and then, you know, the next three, four, six digits here. This is all based on your local IP. So even if I would have put in a worker name like that P2X, it would be P2X001133. So when it comes to these, I don't even worry about really changing it around. Maybe if you had multiple, you might put like a one, a two, a three or something, just so that it kind of has that in front of all this. But right now we can see what's going on. So I'm gonna let it sit for about 10, 15 minutes. We'll come back and give you an idea of what the current estimated hash rate is for Alephium. All right, so we are currently at around 37.8 gigahash. Obviously, you gotta wait for a full 24 hours to really see how well it does, but that's it, guys. That is pretty much how you do set up this miner. Now remember, if you plan on mining other coins, if they are still on the same algorithm, you do not need to do the burn process. Simply switch pools or, you know, switch coin addresses and so on, and that's all you gotta do. Now, if you do swap to a different algorithm for those coins, you will have to burn that algorithm. And again, it does not save them all. It's all individual. So hopefully this video did help you out. All right, guys, so there we have it. Hopefully you did enjoy that video. And if you are looking for these, maybe you gotta watch it two or three times, get everything memorized before yours actually does show up, so you're ready to go and you don't have any delays. Like, it took me a long time to do all that deciphering when I first got it. So this should get you up and running a lot faster than what it took me. So thank you for checking it out, guys. You can email laura@jinglemining.com or just use that code down in the description with code RabidMining for 1% off. I think these are gonna become very popular miners here because, one, you can jump on all these Caspa forks, Carlson Hash, it looks like Pyron may be coming soon as well. Don't quote me on that, but I'm assuming it's going to be coming. So as these forks emerge, you can jump on them with a lot of hash rate before they're even listed and scoop up a ton of coins. Thank you for watching. I'll see you on the next one. Rabid out.